Hi, this is Ken from Homebrew Audio. Let's talk about an effect in Reaper called ReaTune that you can use to create vocal harmonies. ReaTune is a plugin effect that is part of Reaper when you first install it, so you don't need to worry about downloading or installing anything. It was designed primarily, as described in the Reaper manual, to help you correct the pitch on your recorded media items. This is commonly used with vocals. But it can also be used for other things as well, such as tuning an instrument using the Tuner tab, like this, and for creating harmony tracks from one vocal track, which is what I'll show you in this video. There are lots of ways to produce vocal harmonies, the most obvious being to have the singers actually sing the harmony parts. The next most common method, which is what I usually do, is to sing all the harmony parts myself. It's also possible to create harmonies, though, using software. Some programs, like Antares Harmony Engine and Vielklang Instant Harmony, are devoted to vocal harmony, and some of those are demonstrated in other videos. Those programs do a great job, but they can be pretty expensive. So if you want to use software to create harmonies but don't have the budget for one of those dedicated programs, there are two ways to do it in Reaper, using Reaper's own plugins. One way is to use the Revoice effect. I did a video on that already. Today, we'll see how to do it using ReaTune. So, let's start with a single vocal track with some singing on it. So, open up a track by double-clicking here. Click here to record, and then you would click down here to do some singing. When you're done, just hit the stop button. What I'm going to do is insert a track that I sang earlier. If you, too, already have a vocal track, you can just go to Insert, Media File. Let's take a listen to the solo track.
For if you shed your blood with me, you are my brother. And men in England now abed shall feel a curse. They were not here to fight with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
On the recorded version of that song, there are lots of harmonies, so I could put in another track and sing one harmony, then put in another track and sing the other harmony, or get somebody else to come in and help me, or I can use ReaTune. To do that, we're going to need a track for the first harmony, so double-click here to create a second track. Now we want to add ReaTune, so click on the FX button on the second track. Make sure you click on Kakos, Reaper's parent company, to see the Kakos plugins, and select ReaTune. Double-click, and you'll be presented with this. What we're going to want first is correction. Down here where it says attack time, change that to, say, 20. Now, before we do anything else, click on the X in the upper right corner to close the effects window. We're going to need to put a vocal track on track 2 to create the harmony from. So just click on the media file in track 1, hold down the control button on your keyboard, and drag the audio item down into track 2. You've just copied what was in track 1 to track 2. Now go ahead and mute track 1. Go to the start by clicking this rewind button. And now let's open up the effects window again. Now let's go to manual correction and click the track pitch box. Now you want to play through the track so that you'll have the notes from the singing audio tracked into ReaTune. So click play. And when that's done, come over to the scroll bar on the right and drag that until you find your singing. Then use the scroll bar on the bottom to get to the beginning part of the singing. And we're going to want to start, obviously, down here. So let's zoom in vertically, clicking on this plus button over here. And then we can zoom in horizontally by clicking on that plus button. Now what we want to do is put a check mark in manual correction and uncheck the track pitch box. Now you can just draw a line, and what that line will do is change the pitch of whatever notes occupy the same vertical space there, and it will raise them up. I just stuck that in. Let's see what it would sound like.
For if you shed your blood with me.
Obviously that's wrong, but you could hear how it changed the notes. Let's go ahead and click on one of the little handles on the line and hit the delete button on your keyboard. I happen to know for this song that for if, the notes for the harmony should be A. So I'm going to draw a line right there, and let's see what that sounds like. Let's click here.
For if you...
Okay, so for if is correct. Now I put a line where you should be, and I believe that should be a G. Check it.
For if you shed your...
That is correct. For if you is correct. If it weren't, I could just drag this line up.
For if you shed...
No, that's not right. And just keep dragging it until you find the right note. So you'll just continue in that fashion all the way across the song, placing the blue lines where the harmony note should be, the red lines representing the original melody. And keeping in mind that this is a free method of doing this, the corrected note, the harmony notes, are going to sound a little bit computery, but here is what the first harmony sounds like.
Shed your blood with me, you are my brother. And men in England now abed shall feel a curse. They were not here to fight with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
So now that the first harmony's done, we're going to do the same thing for the second harmony. So let's create another track. Let's mute the second track. And let's drag the melody down to, you can do it from either track. I'm just going to do it from track one. Copy it down to the third track. So come up here, hold the control button down to get the plus sign, which means you're copying, and drag that down to the third track and let go. Then add the retune effect. Go to correction, change this 250 to about 20. Click on manual correction. Click on track pitch. Rewind to the beginning, click play. Now scroll down and find the notes. Zoom in vertically, zoom in horizontally, and click on manual correction. Unclick track pitch and start drawing in your notes. And we magically skip to the end where I have drawn in all of the harmony parts here. This is for the high harmony. Now let's go ahead and unmute the other tracks. And because the harmony doesn't come in until Shed Your Blood, I am going to trim the harmony tracks to eliminate the For If You part, because that's only the melody. And let's take a listen to how it sounds so far.
For if you shed your blood with me, you are my brother. And men in England now abed shall feel a curse. They were not here to fight with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
So, it's actually pretty cool. It's still a little bit computery. So, one thing we can do there to minimize that is to turn down the volume on the harmony tracks. Let's turn those down by about 3.4, whatever. And let's pan these about 60% left and 60% right and take a listen again.
For if you shed your blood with me, you are my brother. And men in England now abed shall feel a curse. They were not here to fight with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
You can add reverb. You can try turning the harmonies down even more. You can add some more harmonies. There are lots of other things you can do. But this is a quick demo of how to do three-part harmony using a free software addition to Reaper. So you don't have to buy anything but Reaper. It already comes with it. It's called ReaTune.